Welcome by AA's Art. My name is Ilkjan Wiersma and today we're gonna paint this swimming tiger in acrylics. And before we do that, I would like to point out that this painting has been nominated, and I'm really, really happy about that because it's the first time I ever have a painting or drawing been nominated. And I will talk about it a little bit more after the tutorial. So first we're gonna watch the tutorial.
And I start out to laying just the first color, the first green color, so I don't fight that white of the canvas so much. And you see me doing here a little bit of airbrushing. I just was testing out some strokes I can make with the airbrush for the effects in the water. But later on I discovered that I could do easily with the brush as well, and that was a little bit handier for me for this painting. But sometimes I just like to try some new things out, so that's why you saw me using the airbrush just a little bit. I start the tiger with a base gray, and from there I'm layering my my hairs and my different shapes. And I like to start out with a black stripes on the tiger. It's much handier for me to notice where things should go. And here you see quite some hairs I've done, but I'm missing a clip of that, so I'm so sorry that I couldn't put it in this tutorial. But here you see me continuing that fur. And if you want to know how I do that, I have a I had a tutorial up last week where I show you a little bit more of quite a bit more how I like to paint fur. So I will have a link pop up by now if you wanna see that as well. I'm doing a little bit more explaining of the brushes and that sort of things. And for this painting I was trying out combining different colors. I didn't stick as much with the colors with the actual reference photo, but I introduced some colors I thought that would fit in nicely to give the tiger a bit vibrant, of more vibrant colors. And I personally like it. I did use some yellow, some orange and some purples on the tiger to let the tiger pop out a bit more. And it is a process of layering, so I build up my layers. I continue working on previous sections I've been to build up those colors, to build up the lines and to give the fur more depth. And can do some adjustments on fur where it did go in a little bit in the wrong direction, that sort of thing. So and also on the water, you want to watch the reference photo quite often, because it's very important you get the feel of those shapes. I'm not copying exactly the shapes, but I want to get the feel and of those shapes, and therefore I need to know which direction they go. And I'm layering the water. I'm putting in the first lines and doing some glazing, put in another lines, doing glazing again. And that's basically the process I repeat again and again until I like it. So it's quite easy, but you have to go in and put in the layers it takes. And also on the whiskers, I had to watch closely the direction the whiskers go, because you can see this is actually a photo of the finished piece, and the tips of the whiskers, the longest whiskers, were in the water, so they changed a little bit the direction and the colors there. So I had to adjust those to give the feel that those whiskers are in the water. And this is the end piece. I hope you like it. And like I said, I like how those colors make the tiger stand out a bit more.
Well, I hope you liked that tutorial. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below this this video. And like I said earlier on, this painting has been nominated, and I'm so happy about it because it's the first time I ever sent a piece in, And yeah, after 4 years of almost everyday practice, it's such an honor to be there with to join that competition with a painting. And yeah, only that is also feels all almost like winning something, because it's so nice, and it's yeah, it's so nice that people like the things you make. I can hardly describe it what that had done with me, but yeah, I'm so happy with it. And yeah, if you like to help me winning that contest or be one of the winners, because the first 51 will join in an art show, you know, and that will be amazing, of course. So yeah, I hope to be one of those 50 people who may join that art show. And so if you like to help me and you want to give me your vote, that would be awesome, of course. You can follow the link in the description below, and I will add to it what you have to do to give your vote and to make it count, because you have to click on vote, and then the site will guide you to a message that is about this painting, and you also have to like that photo of this painting there. And if you do those two steps, your vote is counting. So please, if you like the vote, take those steps, and yeah, thereby you will support my work by hopefully winning a nice prize in this competition. Yeah, that's it and done. If you like my work, if you want to follow me, you can follow me on Facebook, on Instagram, and also on my own website. I have also those links put in the video description below this video. And for now, if you like this tutorial, this painting, or my other works, please subscribe to my channel. I would really love that. And if you're gonna vote, thank you very, very much. Bye-bye.